From the Mumbai studios of Republic TV, it's time for The Debate.
Debate at 10, powered by Nissan Magnite.
Providing an impetus to the entire vaccination process in the national capital, there's one more drive-through being inaugurated today inside the Moolchand, the hospital in the national capital. I'll request my camera person to show you the visuals of the number of cars that have already lined up here inside the Moolchand hospital premises. You can see one after another, they have all lined up to get their jabs done. And as we know that vaccination in the national capital is very necessary, looking at the fact that the kind of bout that national capital faced during the second wave was very massive. This is the kind of counter that has been set up inside the premises of the Moolchand Hospital. We are joined by Mr. Vibhu Talwar here, who is the trustee and he manages the Moolchand Hospital. Sir, could you please highlight that this is the first drive-in inside a hospital. So how it would be different from other drive-ins, and how will it, you know, facilitate the people who are getting inoculated here?
Right. To answer this, yes, is one of the first drive-in in a hospital in Delhi. And what we've noticed is that since the third wave, there's a lot of apprehension in the families of coming out and going to a hospital, or even coming out and going to an RWA to get vaccinated. So we heard the voice of the customer, and we decided that, you know, it's important for Moolchand to step up and create an environment which facilitates people coming out from their home feeling comfortable to get vaccinated. You know, the irony is that the only way we are going to progress is that if people get vaccinated. But there's a little bit of a vaccination fear to go out in the public and get vaccinated. So I think this environment, if you see out here right now, of how you can get vaccinated in a car, which is a very smooth process, and more importantly, if there is any adverse event which happens, we have all our doctors present on site. We also have our ambulances here and an entire paramedical team.
Thank you, sir. If you could just walk along with us and tell us that what kind of arrangements that have been done to, you know, ease out this entire process, what is happening one by one, what are these counters?
So essentially the first counter is the registration counter. In the registration counter, the details of the patient are put along with the COVID number. After the registration counter is done, then there is a payment which is collected. Payment, typically we notice that people are paying through Paytm, yeah, which, you know, ensures that there is no physical transfer of money. After that, the vaccination shot is given. And in fact, a vaccination shot is being given right now. And after the vaccination shot is given, the car goes to a designated car parking space ahead. Okay. This entire process takes less than, you know, a couple of minutes.
Okay.
And then they wait there for 30 minutes. Yeah. They are also given a piece of paper which has their waiting time in it. Okay. And once they spend the 30 minutes, the beauty of this process is that the exit is, is adjacent to the where the garden is.
So this is an entire process that is being followed at the Moolchand Hospital in the national capital.
COVID cases are at a downfall, but as we have been seeing, many people suffering to get a bed. Well, now this place we are standing at is one of the inaugurated ones, which is launched by the government of Telangana and the Lord's Church, where these are the mobile critical care buses which are launched, and each bus has 8 beds with oxygen beds facility where they can treat COVID patients for many in the rural areas as well. And also, as you can see, each bus has all the facilities in regard with beds, oxygen, oximeter, and also each bus will be having a doctor and 8 nurses to treat the COVID patient. And also at the same time, they are the most of its focus will be on the COVID or on the rural areas of the Telangana state. And also at the same time, these mobile critical care buses will be move from one district to other district as the demand increases for the citizens and all the basic facilities. And also the patients will be charged at a minimal rate, and if any patient is from a poor background, then they will be given free treatment here for getting COVID treated at this mobile critical care buses.
It is rightly said that necessity is the mother of invention, and the Human Jammu organization, or NGO, has proved this right as they are providing these high-flow oxygen meters to those in distress without any cost. And the specialization in this is that this is indigenously designed oxygen flow meter. We'll speak to Mr. Kiran Vatal, who is the founder of this organization. Mr. Vatal, at a tough time, we have seen that many hands have come to help, and now you are giving these free of cost. We will speak about the architecture of this later, but how you are catering to the demands of the people?
As you know that in this pandemic, there have been lot of shortage of medical emergency equipments. And particularly 10-15 days back, when there was patients who have to give oxygen supplements, but because of for want of this flow meter, we couldn't give them. Then we made a flow meter just like this to cater the immediate demand. Later on, we thought it is better to have our own flow meter. And for that, I contacted Mr. Mohinder Singh Ji, who is a highly skilled person and an entrepreneur here. And then after the 60 to 70 hours, our hard work, team hard work, and the technical skill with the technical skill of Sardar Mohinder Singh Ji, we have built this flow meter, which is at par with the flow meter we find from Indian market. And particularly when there is a lot of blackmailing and hoarding in the Indian market, and particularly the low quality of Chinese material which is coming out, we wanted to show China that we can produce our product here in India also.
Really very important, because I'll request Sarjeevan to show you this indigenously made flow meter. This has been made using all the things that were available in the local market, though they have to procure this thing, which is main part of this flow meter from Ludhiana, but they have made it on their own. And we'll try to speak to Mr. Mohinder Singh, who has made it. Mohinder Singh ji, mujhe aap ye bataiye, ye idea jab aapko aaya to kitni dikkatein hui, ki aapne bataya Ludhiana se सामान लाया, कैसे आपने मैनेज किया?
साहब से क्योंकि मार्केट बंद थी, लॉकडाउन लगा हुआ था, सामान कोई नहीं मिल रहा था, फिर हमने कुछ सामानें दुकानें खिला कर अपने बाप की वजह से दुकानें खिला कर कुछ सामान लिया, कुछ हमें फिर अल्मोड़ी की राड़ नहीं मिल रही थी, वो हमें फिर लुधियाने जाना पड़ा, लुधियाने से हमने राड़ लाई, राड़ ला के फिर हमने लेथ मशीन पर इसका काम किया और काम करके इसको तैयार किया।
ये बताइए कि जो दूसरा फ्लो मीटर मार्केट में आता है, उसके दाम और इसके दाम में कितना फ़र्क है?
वो जो है 2400-2500 रुपये का उसका रेट लिखा हुआ है, कम से कम 1500-1600 का देते हैं, और वो भी मार्केट में मिलते नहीं हैं। हम इसको 500-600 रुपये हम बेच देते हैं, लेकिन हम इसको फ्री कास्ट में देंगे।
This is really very important, because it is coming at a time when there is a high need of the oxygen, high flow oxygen meters, and they are not available, and there is a meter that can also manage this. You can see these are the cylinder, and they are giving the high flow oxygen. So this is the need of the hour, and these people from the Jammu, they have come forward. They have come forward with an idea that can save as many as n number of lives with this kind of initiative. With Sarjeevan Kumar, Gursimran Singh for Republic Media Network.
The unlock process has officially begun from the first week of June, and some construction activities along with industrial works have resumed working. In fact, in the central part of the national capital as well, here we see the people crawling back to normalcy, and this entire market, which used to wear a very deserted look during the pandemic, is now moving towards normalcy, and we can see a lot of vehicles parked here along with the medical shops, a few of the eateries, bakeries, and also the restaurants are open here. Let's actually go across to the restaurant owner here who owns the restaurant, who has also been suffering a lot of losses as well. Sir, bahut zyada losses hue honge during the pandemic, but now unlock ka jo pura process hai wo shuru ho chuka hai. What is the difference jo aap notice kar rahe hain?
Difference, ma'am, as you can see on the roads, traffic ho gaya wapas. People are moving out of their houses. Yeah. And because ek ded mahine se log ghar pe the for like 6-8 weeks. So now people are coming out, they want to eat chaat and everything, which they can't make at home.
Correct.
But still people are still very worried and they're scared. They don't want to, you know, act. The purchasing power is not there in the people because they're not earning for the past more than six weeks. But yeah, people are coming, they want to eat something, they get it packed because right now only there's only takeaway or delivery.
Yeah.
And we have with online delivery with Swiggy and Zomato also.
Okay.
And but slowly people are coming out and it's good to see that.
You know, it's good to see that.
Things are becoming normal slowly.
What are the losses that you have been bearing since the lockdown? Because it's basically history repeated itself, and we saw another lockdown with the second wave.
Again, it happened in March and after in April.
Yeah.
See, all the losses we have to bear, electricity is there, and all the utilities we have to pay,
yeah.
Salary we have been giving.
Yeah.
Some of the staff members, they voluntarily went to the villages because they wanted to. They thought the villages have, there's a better scope there, they can survive in the village and in the cities. But we have been giving the salaries and all kind of loss, and plus it's a perishable food item.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to, you know, it's very hard for us to calculate how much we have to make, how much we will be able to sell at the end of the day. Because next morning it's all finished. Yeah.
Correct.
So losses are there, and we really want the government to help this industry, the hospitality industry, tourism industry, all together, not just my restaurant or neighboring shop, but every this whole industry in totality is suffering for the past 1 year.
The COVID-19 restriction in the state are likely to be relaxed after June 7. Addressing a press conference in New Delhi, Assam's Chief Minister Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma said that there have been sign of improvement with the decreasing positivity rate in the state. The curfew, which has been imposed from 11 a.m. to 5 a.m. in the morning, might get relaxed further. However, the normal restrictions will be in place till the scenario develops further. He also said that in the month of June, the state will receive around 15 lakh doses of vaccine, whereas in the month of July, another 30 lakhs vaccines will arrive in the state. Right now, we are outside the Mahendra Mohan Chaudhary Hospital in Guwahati, a dedicated COVID care hospital, and it can be understood that with the discharge rate increasing further, there have been some relief and respite to the medical staffs, as well as the number of occupied beds are being cleared too.
All the main political parties in the state of Kerala has put their best foot forward to help the state fight the COVID pandemic. Here is a report. Various political parties at their own levels are working and helping the community at large. I'm at Vattiyurkav, where you can see the members of the Yuva Morcha are sanitizing this locations. Now, for the last few days, the Chief Minister has eased the lockdown and has ensured that more shops can be opened, and has brought in some critical, taken away some critical restrictions. So at such times, number of people who are coming on the road, it's increased. As you can see, the the traffic has also increased, and during such times these young guys are working and sanitizing different public places. Let's ask them what do they have to say about it. So yes, tell me your name is?
My name is Akhil. Huh? Akhil.
Akhil, so how many of you guys are there together?
We are now here is only two group, including one group contains three members, and a lot of people are going for other sides.
So on a daily basis you do this?
Yeah, daily basis.
For how long have you been doing?
Really this is going to do like negative houses and common places.
How many?
The negative, COVID negative houses and...
So basically those houses where people have been positive and then they recovered.
Yeah.
Those houses you go and do.
Yeah.
So far how many houses has Yuva Morcha done? Estimate
250 plus. This calculation only in all of our ward.
Okay. How many volunteers are there with Yuva Morcha in this Vattiyur camp?
Approximately 55 or something.
So that's about 55 such youths are there in Vattiyurka who are working at different levels. The sanitization work is going on. As you can see, every day they do this at the suburbs in Thiruvananthapuram at Palappur. The young DIY workers have come up with a novel idea, and that is all the homes which have been tested positive, where young children reside, they don't get to go out or get to buy sweets or anything, any snacks. So the young DIY volunteers have created a novel idea, and what they have done, they have made packages of these snacks and savories, and they are personally handing it over to those homes which has been tested positive. And all these people cannot go out, but there are young children in the age group who are below 13 years old, and they would want to eat some snacks and relish something. For more than 17 days, they cannot go out. So the DIY workers has come up with this novel idea. So let's talk to them what they have to say. അപ്പോൾ എങ്ങനെയുണ്ടായിരുന്നു ലൈക്ക് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഈ ഐഡിയ എപ്പോഴാണ് തോന്നിയത്?
നമ്മളിപ്പോൾ ഇത് കോവിഡിൻ്റെ രണ്ടാം തരംഗം അതിരൂക്ഷമായി നിൽക്കുന്ന സാഹചര്യത്തിലാണ്. ഈ കല്ലൂർ പ്രദേശം എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഒരു ഗ്രാമപ്രദേശമാണ്. അപ്പോൾ സ്വാഭാവികമായിട്ടും അതിൻ്റെ പരിമിതികളുണ്ട്. അന്നന്ന് ജോലി ചെയ്ത് ജീവിക്കുന്ന ആളുകളാണ് ബഹുഭൂരിപക്ഷവും ഇവിടെയുള്ളത്. അപ്പോൾ അതുകൂടി
ഇത് എത്ര പേർക്ക് ഇതുവരെ കൊടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞു? നിങ്ങൾ
നിലവിൽ 110 വീടുകളിൽ കൊടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞു.
സോ വാട്ട് ഹീസ് സേയിങ് ഇസ് ദാറ്റ് സോ ഫാർ ദിസ് യങ് വോളണ്ടിയർ ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഹാസ് ഗിവൻ snacks and savories to 110 homes which have been infected with COVID, where there are young children. Correct? Okay. And so how long do you plan to do this?
ഇതിപ്പോൾ ഇന്നും കൂടി കൊണ്ട് പൂർത്തിയാക്കാനാണ് തീരുമാനിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇന്നും കൂടി ആകുമ്പോൾ ഏകദേശം 30 വീട് കൂടി ആകുമ്പോൾ 140 വീട് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ആകും. നമ്മുടെ ഈ പ്രദേശത്ത് നമ്മുടെ ഈ മേഖലാ കമ്മിറ്റിക്കാരും അകത്ത് വരുന്ന 140 വീടുകളിൽ പൂർത്തിയാവും. ഇതിൻ്റെ രണ്ടാം ഘട്ടം ഓരോ ആഴ്ചയും വെച്ച് ചെയ്യാനാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ തീരുമാനിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഏകദേശം
സോ വെരി വെരി നോവൽ ഇനീഷ്യേറ്റീവ്, വെരി യുണീക്ക്. ഇൻ ഫാക്ട് they are planning to cover 140 homes where there are children. They have even identified where there are young children, and those children will be handed over these packets which contain biscuits, sweets and salty savories and other savories as well. I am at the Kerala Pradesh Congress Committee COVID control room, which has been set up in Thiruvananthapuram at their very office, where since April 19th a bunch of volunteers have been working as a call center to help people across Kerala help fight the pandemic in different ways. And these are youngsters who have completed their masters in social work. They are experienced people, and they have been working as a call center. Three hotline numbers and a WhatsApp number are being used to talk to different people with different needs, whether it's psychological need, whether it's need for food, whether it's for getting an ambulance. All these services, this young batch of about 12 people who work around the clock, 24 hours, are working. Along with that, these guys have been committed to this particular job since April 19. So let's ask them what is the kind of work that has come. Yes, Tanya, so how does it feel like since April 19th, how many calls altogether has this team handled so far?
It's been actually two months since we started this program under the guidance of Dr. Lal sir, and our team includes frontline doctors, psychologists, counselors and everyone. And Actually, we receive almost 500 calls from each district all over Kerala, and mainly it is about
500 calls per day.
Yeah, per day. And mainly it is about vaccine related queries and slot availability, and also some people they call for counseling support and medications. And we are able to, and with the help of DCC, we are able to connect them, and then we are able to follow up with them.
Dr. Lal, who has been associated with the World Health Organization, has worked as a medical doctor, and he is here, and he has been coordinating along with his team of two other doctors who are also available, medical doctors who are available to talk to patients and give the sufficient help. Thank you, doctor, for talking to Republic. So how did this whole idea, like if you can put it in a short way, how has this call center and this help people, in how do you evaluate it?
KPCC president Mr. Mullapalli Raman, he told me we have to start a control room for COVID. So naturally, I'm part of the Congress party. I'm a medical doctor who's trained in public health also. So the next day we started a control room. So what we did is we created a mechanism that it will continue to work. Now it's more than a month. So what we did is we engaged four volunteers who will take the phone calls. So we have three identified phone numbers and WhatsApp number also. So they get calls from all over the country, I should say, because this number is there everywhere. So they talk to them, and some people need information, some people need some help for getting ambulance, some people want to know about bed availability, these kind of inquiries. But if something is there beyond their information or beyond their capacity, they are trained social workers. So we have a second layer of young doctors, so who will answer the medical questions, medical doubts and things like that. So they are capable of answering all the basic doubts. If there is somebody needs a help of a specialist doctor, particular specialty, so these doctors will refer them to such a specialist. And at above that level, there are people coordinating like me. I do the medical coordination, and there is another KPCC secretary who does the political coordination. We have control rooms in all the districts. District Congress committees, they are running the control room.
As somebody who has worked with the World Health Organization as a public health expert, how has it been different, like especially the second wave of COVID? How did you feel? Was there a lot of pressure for the team?
Not just for this team alone. See, for the whole state, there's a lot of pressure. So a couple of things happened. We did a good job because Kerala has a good health system. We have very good government hospitals and large numbers of private hospitals. Some 80% of the doctors and nurses are in the private sector, and 70% of the people also go there. So we have a compact system. But there were some issues in the management of COVID. Because of different reasons, I should say the government, to some extent, they mismanaged it. Not deliberately, but maybe wrong advices and things like that. Then there were elections, so they had to prove that whatever they did was right, which is not science, actually. If there are mistakes, we have to correct and rectify. Then what happened is we were not prepared for the second wave. That's a fact. Second wave, we did not even expect a second wave. That's why there were celebrations saying that, oh, we got rid of COVID, which was not the situation.
What I want to ask you is, like, in terms of the specific service that you're rendering, how has your experience been so far? Like, how do you feel about it?
So we knew that. No, see, when a calamity occurs, especially a pandemic, long pandemic like this happens, see, everything cannot be solved with your medical knowledge. So all problems are not medical problems. And COVID itself is not a health issue alone. It's a social issue. So there can be other issues. People don't have money. So all people are not calling here for clearing their doubts. Somebody wants an ambulance. He doesn't have money. Or somebody wants to take someone to a hospital. He doesn't have support. So these kind of things. And there are instances when people needed counseling also. So a couple of people died in their home. So those people are no more. But the people who are living, they have a lot of stress. They don't know places to call, or they don't have people to call, because it's COVID, nobody comes to your home. So they are isolated, so they need counseling, they need to talk to someone. So these kind of services, yeah.
With more hands on deck to take on the COVID pandemic, the political party and its different affiliations have come forward to help. and this has certainly been a boon for the state, which is still fighting the pandemic very hard. With video journalist Mani S. from Thiruvananthapuram, Ashwin Nandakumar for Republic TV.
Let's take a look at vaccines and indemnity. What is indemnity and which are the companies that are seeking indemnity from the government of India? Well, indemnity basically means protection from any legal liability. Well, indemnity grants protection for these vaccine manufacturers against injury or death caused by these vaccines. Now, indemnity also protects companies against claims of vaccine side effects, which is very important, and that's why these vaccine manufacturers are seeking indemnity from the government of India. But can they be prosecuted? Well, vaccine makers can't be sued if indemnity is granted by the government of India. That's a very important point here. Who has applied for indemnity? Well, Pfizer and Moderna want indemnity to export vaccines to India. That's their basic contention. They say, if we get indemnity, only then will we come to India, and only then we will export vaccines to India. So who else has also applied for indemnity? Well, Covishield manufacturer SII has also applied for indemnity today. They say that they want a level playing field. If the government of India gives indemnity to the foreign vaccine makers, that's Pfizer and Moderna, then Indian manufacturer should also get indemnity. So Covishield manufacturer SII says that all vaccine makers, both Indian and abroad, must get indemnity. Now, all eyes are on the Indian government. Will the Indian government give indemnity to vaccine manufacturers? Let's wait and watch.